Всем привет! This video is going to be the most casual I seem to be able to produce since, well, there are many reasons. And first of all, I really feel like I love you all guys for bearing with me, for watching all this stuff. This is, I can't express the importance of all that you do here for me. And today is a very harsh day. It's been a hard week. I'm on the verge of a big project which is going to last, I don't know, maybe for 6 weeks, maybe for 2 months, and it's been a real hard training this whole week. I'm so tired. So I just wanted to chat with you and to relax myself first of all. And it's actually very, very difficult to me to make something, you know, something I would be willing to change, to make perfect, which I know I would never achieve though. And you know, at this point, I just thought that if I will be waiting for any long to make another video, I will just end up doing no videos at all, since the neighbors are so noisy, I don't have chance to record. So that's why I'm in the kitchen right now, since when I'm in my usual space, when I'm in the room, oh my gosh, you would be surprised how many pieces of news you're going to hear from above. And you'd actually be lucky if that's just their TV or them arguing, because most of the time it's actually them fighting or having sex after they fight. So this is really challenging for me to make new videos this year. Last year I didn't have those neighbors, and it was easier to me. So anyway, I've been thinking that for an ASMR channel, at least for such a small and, you know, kind of intimate ASMR channel I have here, I need to be as honest and open to you as I possibly can. To me, this is the key to creating this atmosphere I personally like in those videos. I like it when an ASMR artist chats with you as if you have a friend most of the time, best friend. This is so dear to me, so I was always looking for channels like this, and they are actually quite rare. So I hope you understand me and will be able to relax together. So please, if you hear all those sounds, all that white noise, guys, I honestly don't know how you get rid of it, since to me it seems impossible at the moment. Probably I will figure it out, but right now I don't have any soundproof equipment, and I don't have the chance to record when no one's at home. This is simply not an option, so please, if it's possible for you to wait for a while for me to grow in this respect, I think all of us will be rewarded. Well, that sounded not very tempting, probably, to my viewers, but this is kind of a disclaimer, so sorry guys if I'm disappointing any of you, but it's really important for me to keep it enjoyable for myself to make. To cut the talking, I actually brought some items and I keep them in this kind of wash bag. This is also a present from my friend. So now I have two wash bags. I don't really use such kind of things, but this one is really cute and it's made of two kinds of materials, it seems, and I like that really about it. And on the outside it's textile fabric. Sorry for the cars, as usual. And on the inside, there's some crinkly sort of padding, lining, sorry. So the sound is, well, kind of layered, two layers of fabric, two layers of materials produce. Two layers of sand. Let's see what's inside. First of all, here's this. This is kind of a serum for your hair. It's called Vitamins for Hair, actually. This is from Russian market. That's really, really cheap and kind of useless if you look at the ingredients. But I really like the way it smells and the way it sounds. It's really runny, so the texture is just like that of water. And I can sprinkle it. This. I get a certain feel of nostalgia from this smell. I don't know why, probably it resembles some kind of, I don't know, I would say my mom's perfume, but my mom has never been using any perfume. So I don't know, probably the perfume of my first teacher or something like that. You know, guys, I just realized that the sun is setting and it's going to be dark soon. That's another disappointment for me. I should have called my channel, I don't know, disappointment ASMR artist. Please forgive me. Actually, I don't like it when bloggers, you know, beg forgiveness from their audience. It just sounds really sometimes artificial, sometimes even pathetic. But I can't help it. So, now, when would unsubscribe after this huge mess of a video? I would know that you did forgive me and won't be repeating this crap again. I already feel like most of you are really my friends here, even though we might have just exchanged a couple of comments or messages. But I'm actually surprised at how many nice people there are around on the web, on the YouTube. The most marvelous thing is, you know, the environment here is usually quite aggressive. So when I first met those nice girls and guys who said nice things to me, I thought, oh my gosh, this must be some kind of a prank. They can't be serious. So nice, so amiable, so sincere sounding even. But now I know that this is what you are about. So that's why I really appreciate your existence, guys. You're cool. You're so cool. You watch the videos. You tell the bloggers what you like and what you don't like. That's brilliant, really. The feedback's so important. It's not too dark. I do not want to switch on the light, since then you will see those, you know, stripes running across the screen at a certain frame rate, because I do not have a proper camera. I hope I will someday, maybe even this year. Maybe in the autumn or in the winter, I don't know. I can only hope. And so if it's becoming too dark, please don't look at the screen and just listen. Hope it's not very loud with the background noise. It seems quite quiet to me at the moment. I do not hear the neighbors. probably they knocked each other out. I know, it's awful. I promise you, when I finally move to the countryside, it will be much, much, much better with the quality of the sound. So the next thing, that'd be this. This is a coconut facial mask, right? And this didn't really suit my skin type when I ordered it, and I found out that too late, so I do not use it on my face. But the smell, again, really, really marvelous. It's just pure coconut, only I think several times stronger. So that's why I keep it. I think I should really switch on the light right now, right? Let me see. According to the mirror I'm holding in front of the phone, it's going to be bearable for another 10 minutes, so let's leave it at that at the moment. Oh my gosh, I hope I'm not going to be ruining all that for this casual approach. I mean, who knows? I like all those, you know, professional kind of videos where you see the person used the green screen, the proper camera, and such videos always feature the 3DO, and well, it's impressive. It's impressive and really I don't know. That's cool. But I can't afford it at the moment. But I really, really, really like to make these lame videos. Here's a perfume bottle. So I'd rather about it rather than keep embarrassing myself in front of you. This is the first and the only one that I bought for myself. Can you see it actually? Yeah. Quite so. And well, just said that was the first and the only bottle I bought for myself, and I have a couple of other perfumes people gave to me as presents, but I'm not you know, I did not know how to choose it properly, how to wear it. But this one seemed just right for me. Well, I'm not gonna be lying to you, not just perfect one, you know, the chosen one. But this smell seems quite nice to me, and most of the time I do not like you know, your regular perfumes. Even when girls at school let me smell theirs, I didn't like most of them since they seemed to me too sweet. So I guess I need something more herbal, something more. What's the word? I do not know. What's the word? I don't know. Spicy, maybe even spicy, but not very pronounced. Something soft and natural, but a bit weird. I need something a bit weird. That's right. And this one, I don't know what the notes in here, what's the basic smell. I love it. It's not ideal to me, but I love it. Although it's been with me for like, probably for 7 or even 8 years. And you can see that I'm an avid user of perfume by the level of what's left in the bottle. This is becoming more and more embarrassing, guys. I don't know if I'm going to upload this. Who needs ASMR that tenses you up instead of relaxing? But I still hope that you can relax to this, since I feel really sleepy and tired and my soul is aching. No, I mean my body is aching because it's been rough days, really rough, 5 days in a row. And I will tell you more if you're interested, but I do not think you are, because I can speak about my work for hours. And most of the time it's gonna be whining and complaining, so I would better spare you of it. Was that grammatically correct? I don't think so. Sorry, I am a translator, but my English is so-so. As the teachers of English taught us at school, that if something's not right, you're going to say that it is so-so. And since then, I've never encountered that phrase in real life, so I'm not sure if English-speaking people actually do say so-so. I guess they do, but it sounds, you know, teachery. Sorry. So, yeah, that's why I feel so spaced out. Completely spaced out. So I don't know what I'm going to do next in the evening. It's only like 8:30, and I don't want to go to bed that soon. I don't want to do that. But, I guess I'm going to go on Steam and just stay up at late as usual. Although it's not a good idea. It's totally. Can a person just go and sleep if you could use this time to play games, to read books, and to record the videos, right? So this is what I put into this wash bag, to this crinkly the first part of the video, and now I'm gonna just switch on the light and continue with a couple of other objects I have here. Let's do that. And here my joints cracking. I feel like I'm really old this year, you know. This is not far from the truth. I'm not 16. Oh my gosh, that sounded really optimistic. I'm not 16, you know, like I'm 20, okay? Come on. What are you doing? Please stop. Stop it. Stop it and tap on an apple. Know this app, I do not show it to you because it looks quite gross, at least on the one side surface. Here's the bright side of an apple. I'm bad with the, how do you call it, aspiration? No. I'm bad at it. I need to do something with that. It surely does not improve my pronunciation. So shall I just make it more explosive? Explosive, explosive, explosive. Apple, 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 apple. Apple, 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 apple. So tapping on an apple. Tapping on an apple. Is what really... me to sleep apparently, and brings much satisfaction. I don't know, I like this sound so much, just like these are many other fruit and vegetables produce. It's so dense. So real, so natural. For that reason, I really like the sound of wood. You can make anything with wood, and I like the sound of it. Doesn't matter, be it, I don't know, splitting the logs or carving something, or just fidgeting with the splinters, anything. I love the wood sounds, tapping on a wooden wall. So listen to this, that's marvelous, I love it. The secret is in the apple's skin. And if you put it on the table, it's becoming even denser. There is also that cool sound when someone is splitting an apple in half with their bare hands, but I don't think I'll be able to do that. The apple is too small and I'm too weak for that. Crackle a bit if I tried oh no, I can't do that. That's too hard and the apple is too small and when I'm trying to do that to an apple I just remember when me and my best friend were in Edinburgh. Is that a way to pronounce it? Oh my gosh, so embarrassing. When we were in Scotland, right, we didn't have anything to eat except for an apple. We have one apple, we have no knife, so what do? We just end up near some famous castle just at the walls of that, I don't know, royal residence, cutting an apple in half with a credit card. I mean, that's the way Russian tourists go in the United Kingdom. That was a nice experience, by the way. And the apple was really tasty. So I actually polished this one with my hands quite alright. It's not shiny except for those gross marks it has. But you know what? It's beautiful anyway since this is an apple. Go home, Apple. You helped us a lot. So, you know, another thing I got here is actually this cute little something. Cute little something. That's the way to put it if you're a linguist, right? No, I don't know. It's actually a coin bag. Coin bag, coin wallet, of a red panda. Red panda is my I forgot the word again. Is an animal I consider very important to my personality. So that's why I have this. It's actually a present, another present, and this was from a person who never knew that a red panda was my, you know the word, I don't, sorry, it was my talisman, mascot, yeah, it was my mascot, and it was incredible because, you know, that's not a very popular animal. It's not a cat, I mean, it's not a dog or even a unicorn. That's a red panda. And Russell didn't know that and gave me that as a present. That was really, really cool. And so, I keep my pins, hair pins, in there. That's why it produces this sound. And this is the elevator producing its own sounds. But if I had to choose between the elevator and the neighbors, I would choose certainly the elevator. Elevator doesn't scream at night. also have a little toy. I also really like it. I don't know from whom, even. I believe it's made of some kind of hard rubber or PVC. It's a dog, and it says little tykes on his collar, and probably many children have played with it before it ended up here at my place. He's nice. He has a big black nose. Dogs are so nice. I want to have a dog someday when I'll be living in my own house. Do you guys, any of you, have your own house, and are you living there for a permanent basis, you know? Because I live in a flat, but I go to the countryside from time to time. Well, it's a rare occasion in the winter, but in the spring, summer, or in the fall, I tend to stay there whenever possible. So cozy. It's not very convenient at the moment. We do not have any bathrooms as such, so it's quite severe conditions, but the place is marvelous. You just look out of the window and here's the forest, here's the river. Unfortunately for the last year, there's also a new house being built, and there's gonna be more houses, new houses, but it would be selfish to live it all for ourselves. People are still coming to live there from Moscow, by the way, mostly. And I am quite far from Moscow. It's like at least two hours ride, depending on what you're taking, be it a train, a car, or else. So sometimes it's 3 hours if there's traffic, if there are traffic jams. So you see, that's why I'm so tired. I've been commuting for this whole week to Moscow, so it's roughly 4 hours of commuting a day, both ends. And it's very time consuming and effort consuming, even though I've read quite a lot during my trips. But still, I would better be sleeping at home, especially the first day when I had to get up at 4 freaking a.m. Oh my gosh, I need to sleep and you need to, so come on, relax and sleep. Besides, I have only one object left here, and this is a... guess what? Right. This is a gamepad. Ordered it from China, and unfortunately it's wireless, and my old and rusty laptop just doesn't work with wireless stuff, so I just had to buy another one with a wire. It was much cheaper than this one, and I have this one just for another time, just for the pleasure of having it. So since my job is connected to gaming and it's becoming more and more connected to gaming, which is a great joy to me, and I hope it keeps coming this way. Special pleasure to me in playing not only on PC, but well, I play on PC anyway, but I love to use emulators. How do you call them? Special programs to play console games on PC, even though this is a crutch. Just like many kinds of sacrilege, it's very, very pleasant. I like pressing buttons. And just get the grip of gamepad and joystick. This is so, I don't know, it's empowering. So this is totally a no-no talking video. Really, really chatty one. I hope you guys are still with me. I'm probably sleeping, which would be even better. Because I don't want to lose you, I want to keep in touch with you, and keep on sharing our ideas and stuff. Because even though I'm an introvert, I love meeting new people, because there are so many great girls and guys around here. It's incredible. Even though the most of the population is considered to be, you know, well, I'm not sure about the most of the population, but my best friend used to, she's always saying that 90% people on Earth are idiots. And my number is 70, because I don't want to believe in her version, I guess. And this fact is actually get busted by what I see here. What is that? What was that sound? Was that my phone going off? Ooh, it's gonna be off in 30 seconds, so please, 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 please forgive me. Have a good night.